Jan Morant's got the ball here for East Rutherford. Leading by five. Now, here's Isaac. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
And this is Fox's role. He's the floor general for this team, and that includes setting his guys up.
Isaac down low. They shoot again, and they convert a pass on attempt number three. Isaac's got his second basket of the night. Outside, Fox. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Fox.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
East Rutherford leading by seven. Here's Morant.
And one of the younger players to enter the 2019 draft. Morant flies beyond his years.
Shooting from East Rutherford.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for East Rutherford.
They've been effectively aggressive here in the first half, driving to the hoop with authority and getting a lot of their points right at the rim.
And also, it's been a positive to watch that they've attacked the paint offensively as well. It's really been about the balance that they've shown. Man, they are just living at the line.
There's the three. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
Fox with it. Wiseman picks him up. And the Bruins, another three.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring him back.
It's Morant with the drive. Off target at the rim. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Right wing. Here's Collins. And it's sent back by Isaac.
Oh, how about the read from the young fella? Isaac is dependable at anticipating when to go for the block.
Got a hand on it. And so, both teams trading buckets as we end the first quarter. It's East Rutherford up by three. After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on... We're back with you, all set to bring you more action from game three. And looking at what we've seen, guys, from East Rutherford so far, what do you think?
Just they've gotten to the line with tremendous consistency here through the first period.
Yeah, I like the attitude they've shown coming in here. I mean, really applying pressure and trying to give this crowd nothing to cheer about.
Here's Bates. Second chance shot. That's tipped. Now Fox, still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Kicks it out to Leonard. Back to Fox. It's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. And this game is tied up now.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Here's Bates. and it's denied by Fox.
On defense, Fox is so crafty. Uses all of his natural talents to disrupt your shot.
Quarter number two. We're about a minute in. Here's Bates.
It's been a really tough quarter for him. And he cannot get his shots to drop.
First team foul.
Here's Fox. Driving in. And got tapped on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Outstanding at Nike into the paint. I love how assertive Fox is. I mean, he forces the D to act.
The Bruins getting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe. Fox hits them both. And it's East Rutherford's ball. Trailing by two. Here's Bamba. To the inside. It's blocked. And they get it back. Clock at six. Back to Williams.
East Rutherford.
And East Rutherford calls their first timeout of the game.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
Yeah, they might be pressing a little, forcing some things. This is a good opportunity to calm everyone down.
Substitution for East Rutherford. Ja Morant.
Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played.
Oh, good interior offense. Those passes have to be right on target.
Fox. Here's Leonard. Hits the layup after the sweet pump fake to freeze the D. Leonard's got the lead up to two now for the Bruins.
He was hoping to avoid a third foul before the break. Now he's going to have to sit out until halftime.
And so here is East Rutherford. Morant looking around.
And this has really become a struggle for them. Their shots aren't dropping, and it's reflected on the scoreboard. They need to put everything they have into getting high percentage shots.
Oh, good on that one. So East Rutherford will take it the other way. And it's out of bounds to East Rutherford. Only taking possession.
Great instincts from him to get a hand on that pass and tip it out.
We're just trying to prevent the opposition from getting comfortable. Next time, that one might get picked.
And out of bounds as the Bruins gain possession. It's a close game here in Houston. Down low. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. He has five.
Man, can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Pass to Naji. And there's the drive. It's tipped. They get it back. Five to shoot. Here's Morant. No good on that one. Great D that time from Leonard.
Until he starts knocking down some shots, I don't think the deficit's going to get any smaller.
Here's Fox. Nice move. Rebound by Williams. East Rutherford trails by four. Here's Bamba. It's deflected. And he recovers it. A second chance effort. Leonard looking over the floor. That's good, and he's now 3 for 4 from the field. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for the Bruins.
They deserve a lot of credit for the defense they've played in the paint here early. Contesting shots, blocking shots, just making life difficult on the opposing shooters in general.
Yeah, and one thing Clark, I've noticed is how committed their hands have been. Thanks to that, they've gotten a lot of points off the turnover.
John Morant. And finished off by Morant.
Well, you see the burst. Morant, very hard to catch once he gains a step.
Too long in the paint. He was hit with a three-second violation. And this is his second trip to the line in the game. And so he hits the technical free throw. A minute 42 left in the first half. Fox's double. Five on the clock. And stolen by Williams. Here's Morant. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
And he just seemed to have a little more fire in the first quarter that he has in this one. And it showed in all the trips he made to the free throw line. Those have dried up. Probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that
run. Absolutely. And Fox gets it to go. Fox has got the lead up to six now for the Bruins.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
He's not using his head this quarter. He's got to get back to finding high percentage shots.
Here's Morant. And finished off by Morant.
Robert Williams.
Man, I love watching this kid play. Morant, he's just electric at the offensive end. He's having a night.
It's good.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Offensive rebound. Pass to Morant. He gets that one to drop. He's now 5 of 12.
That jumper is just looking clean, confident. Very little that Morant can't do.
And the basket is good. He's got 12.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
A pass to Fox. Here's Collins. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Zeke Nagy.
A mid-first round draft pick. Collins continues to make the teams that passed on him regret that decision. Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
Now here's Williams. Back to Morant. Here he goes. And finished off by Morant.
Man, he takes off like a rocket. I mean, there's a suddenness to... Morant's game that most athletes don't have.
That'll do it for the first half. Bruins lead by six. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. And we're back with you as these two teams do battle in their quest for an NBA championship. In the corner, Collins with it. Some nice ball movement by the Bruins. The kick out to Fox. To the middle. Bamba with the block.
And the giant wingspan of Bamba strikes again. Just fantastic at spiking shots in a variety of ways.
Morant outside. And finished off by Morant.
Just the kind of play they need in a game this close.
You know, that's the kind of aggression they want from their floor leader.
This is why they go to him. When the game is tight, he ups his intensity level.
To the paint. Inside. And the officials call him for a three-second violation.
The ball goes to East Rutherford. Substitution for East Rutherford.
East Rutherford trails by four. pass to Bamba. Back to George. Down low. Here's Najee. Now here's Williams. Six on the shot clock. Doesn't go that time. Leonard attacking. Three-pointer. Rebounded by Isaac.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Outside Williams. Outside George. Leonard with the steal. And so they choose to intentionally foul.
You're not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
First team foul.
Timeout called.
East Rutherford.
In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be healthy.
East Rutherford making a switch here. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. Here's Fox. Trains the three-pointer. 8 points for him.
He does all the little things. I mean, he does the big things. I mean, he's got them in front with another outstanding performance.
Takes it inside. Pass to Bamba. Nailed from three-point land.
And crucial that Bamba keeps evolving his perimeter game. Big men like him have to be able to shoot it.
Collins, good. Collins.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Talk about the great competition going on. That's what makes a matchup like this so much fun to watch.
And it's out of bounds to East Rutherford. They'll retain possession. And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Shot clock at five. Pass to George. East Rutherford needs to get a shot off here. Offline from the high post. The Bruins leading by seven. Fires from deep. And the Bruins another three.
They'll be with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
It's Fox with the drive. And it's Fox with the jam.
Yeah, letting it rip. They're just having fun right now.
And they're playing well as a unit, taking shots they know they can make and building this lead.
Count it. And the Bruins lead by 14.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
To end the run, here's Bamba. And the dunk by Bamba.
And how about the 9'6" standing reach Bamba has? I mean, it's unguardable this close. Dunks it with such ease.
Outside, Fox. Kicks it out to Collins. Rebound, East Rutherford. To the middle. Here's George. Good ball movement here by East Rutherford. Good on the bucket.
Bamba.
Bamba's got 7 points in the game.
And I like the decision-making. He's taking what the defense is willing to give him.
Oh, yeah, and that's just a good read on his part. And as usual, his mid-range jumper is on point.
And Fox gets it to go.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Pass to Isaac. To the paint. Here's Bamba. And he banks in the layup. Bamba's got 9 points now in the quarter.
As hot as he's been, it still has to be him who leads the charge and helps turn this game around.
That shot is off. So East Rutherford will take it the other way. Let's it go from deep. And it's John Collins with the rebound. And here's Collins. He'll bring it up for the Bruins. It's a 10-point game. We've got 28 seconds left in the third quarter. From deep. And the Bruins, another three.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
To the inside. Here's George. Good work defensively by Fox. And that basket is going to count. Goaltending, the official call.
Just barely too late and catches it on the way down. He's already in the air there, committed, so can't fault him for going for the block.
What a play! He simply drains it in at the buzzer.
Ringing the bell. That's the way to close a quarter.
Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. The Bruins on top. They lead by 12. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. East Rutherford trails by 12. And he drives in and finished off by Morant.
Man, he's got some pops. Morant loves to attack the rim when he gets the chance. Any chance.
Here's Fox. Sweet move. And that's 2 points on the layup. And the Bruins lead by 12.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
And he makes good on the layup.
And they found the touch from the field here in the second half. It was a struggle in that first.
Rebound, East Rutherford. Up top, Morant. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. Left side, Leonard. It's stolen by Wiseman. Here's Morant. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's going to go on De'Aaron Fox.
First team foul.
One thing Morant does with consistency, I mean, he keeps defenders off balance.
He hits both from the stripe.
And he's been rock solid at the free throw line tonight. A little bit of an unexpected bonus for them.
It's stolen. About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Fox. Morant with it. Now guarded by Fox. Morant, right side. Just five to shoot. And he uses the glass on the layup.
And the D not really doing its job there. A little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint.
Timeout called, the Bruins.
Yeah, things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
Defensive intensity has to pick up, and I'm sure coach is going to let them know that.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
During that break, Frank Vogel had some real words for his team. His demeanor was not one of the coaches. Team was well ahead. He said, this is the time to turn up the heat. make one final push, and try to close out strong. We'll see if they were listening, guys.
Thank you, David. Fox goes in. Nobody near Leonard. It's good from long range. And the Bruins lead by nine.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, and they aren't just chucking up anything. I mean, they're doing a great job of creating quality looks.
Inside, kicks it out to Collins. Outside, Fox. Wiseman with the rebound.
It's a very aggressive defense to prevent the easy lay-in.
For three, the shot misses. The Bruins go the other way with it. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Driving inside. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Well, something you never like to see, but guys, he definitely looks hurt.
And boy, this really doesn't look good. That just the way it happened.
I'm not a doctor, but nothing about that play screams minor injury. Obviously, this could be a real concern.
The Bruins making a switch here. Timeout called, the Bruins.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
Get ready for the Deer Squad!
Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Down low. That will fall for his seventh bucket. 7 for 15 in this game. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Bruins.
They played a heads-up brand of basketball this entire game, and they've got the steals to prove it.
And also, I've been extremely impressed with their interior D. Their rim protection has been as good as it gets.
And that one's good, Morant. Morant's got 13 points in the second half.
If you're Morant and you want to be a star point in the NBA, you have to score off the pick and roll sets.
Out to the wing. To the middle. Lee Bass was put in just the right spot. And the Bruins lead by 11.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher. And coach knows it.
And that's why they're running plays for him. They're getting him the ball and letting him go to work.
Kicks it out to Leonard. This one.